What's good, YouTube? Y'all should know who it is by now.
Of course, Mirage Sniper.
Grim Casaschini. What are we?
The Game Collective.
So, we got this new game. So, it's this worm-based game. You know, it's called Instacia, that's what I think it's called. Instacia.
It starts with an I.
This motherfucker's fun, though, but it starts with something like that, and this, yeah, something in that nature. So, we're gonna start this game off and start talking about the concept. What do you think about the concept, man?
Alright, man. This game, when I was playing it, I didn't even know what type of game it was. As soon as I started, I saw that it was a snake and I started seeing how it moved, I was like, dude, this reminds me of that one game on those old retro phones. I think the game was called Snake. As soon as it reminded me of that, I started playing.
It reminds me a little bit of Centipede.
The Centipede game as well. Actually, it's a little bit more relatable to Centipede than Snake. But just the whole, like, the way on you play Snake reminded me of that.
Gotcha. This game's fun. See, guys, you know, like, if you like Snake or Centipede, it's an old style game, you're gonna like this game. Concept's pretty good. Now, what I like about the concept personally is it's simple. It brings back that retro feeling. You know, you guys know by now, I love retro. So, it's bringing back that nice retro vibe, that simple game, eat shit, grow, and you just try to get a high score. It's basically, Centipede just reminded me of that.
Yep.
And I was happy. I was satisfied. I liked the concept. Things I didn't like about the concept was that it could have been a little more unique. Could have done some new, different aspect to make it a little bit differently. Its own right instead of being like a Centipede game, you know, Snake game. But nonetheless, I like it. What do you think about the concept?
I agree with you. The pros, you know, pretty much the same retro. Pretty much so much fun. Just the whole eating, grow, all that. The cons, most of my cons are pretty much just playability on the controls.
Well, we're not there yet.
Yeah, we're not wait there yet, but I'll wait till that. Other than that, the concept, I'm good. I'm good with just pros. I didn't see not that much content.
Well, for the concept, we gave it a 4. Now let's move on to the graphics. What do you think about these graphics, man? I like these graphics. They're nice and clean. We like to disclose this. It looks better on the screen when you're playing it than it does in this recording for some reason. I don't know why, but it looks better when you play it on your computer.
Yeah, I think the program that we used did not like this game.
Or lowered the quality or something.
Yeah, it probably lowered the quality.
The graphics look a lot better than what it's showing right now.
Yeah, as you can tell from the past videos, the quality is amazing. But this one just came out.
It's weird.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll check that out. Don't worry. The quality is not going to be like this for the next couple videos. We're going to check it out, fix it, and then, you know, come back with better quality.
Graphics. There's no pros and cons to this, it's just pros. Just no cons, pros. I like the graphics. Graphics nice and clean.
Good 3D over the top view.
It's a nice 3D 2.5 dB combination kind of thing going on. And I like it. I really do. I have no cons for this. I don't know if you guys have a con. Please comment and let me know what's up. I don't have any cons for this.
I don't.
But we gave it a 4. Just because there's no cons. But, you know, graphic-wise, you can always go better. But there's no cons. I like it. It fits the game. So, yeah, we gave that a 4. Now the sound. Let me talk about sound. Go ahead. Tell me about the sound.
Okay, guys. Like we've always said, don't keep it similar. Don't keep it the same. Try something new. Try something
variety new. Is key.
Yes. The sound that they had on it was catchy. It actually went with the game, but it was just too repetitive. And repetitive, depending on the game, it's either good or bad. And with this one, it was, you know, bad.
See, now as a game developer myself, what I would suggest is as you get longer, the tempo maybe speeds up a little bit. You know, the gameplay maybe becomes a little bit faster. When you're fighting against enemies, maybe, you know, it's like when they get close to you, something. You know, the sound varies a bit to let them know that you're getting close. Oh shit, you know, like, be ready. Something, some little variations like that I think that would make this game go well as a game developer and as a gamer.
Yeah, actually, yeah. Some sound effects of the enemies nearby or an enemy about to attack.
Something like that will go a long, long way. But nonetheless, they do have some nice sound effects that go with it, but you could have had some more of that. So, we get the sound effect. Now, playability. You may talk about it.
Oh, okay. This is where it was kind of ticking me off a bit, just because it was little tiny, like 100% kind of hard to play.
They had to... 100% kind of hard to play. Understatement, it was hard to play at first.
Yes, it was really hard to play at first. I actually got to give credit to my girlfriend. The first part of the clip that you saw that seemed like it was a professional play. Yeah, that was her. Yeah, my girl is better than me.
Guys, you know how competitive we are. I don't know how he lets this slide. I don't know. Shit won't happen with me. Shit. Not me.
Look,
she won't lose today.
She is better at some stuff. She just got lucky there. That's it. She got lucky. She could be better at me at zombies. I don't give a damn.
See, that where he fucked up. He said his girl's better than him at zombies. Call of Duty's a... Man, you know what kind of shit is this?
Dude, she goes up to 54. I go up to 30.
Hell
that's it.
Hell nah.
Point is...
Ain't no way in hell. My girl about to beat me at some motherfucking zombies. Shit. I bet you I'll be up all night for a whole week by the past that score. Shit. Wear a laptop. I'll be ready. Screw that.
Baby, go to bed.
No.
No. I gotta beat you.
I'm on zombies. It's time to go. I don't care. I don't give a fuck until I beat this score.
I'm about to have sex with you.
I don't give a fuck.
That's bullshit.
Yeah,
I know you're
fuck.
Not.
No, I don't give a fuck.
You put pause.
Shit.
Bang, 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 she and better, then go back to the game.
She better work this shit while I'm on my fucking game. Shit, you hear her in the background when she's trying to mess with me. Get the fuck off. I don't got time for this shit. She know game time is game time, man. Leave me alone.
So back to this.
My bad, guys.
The playability for this, it was just the controls. That's the only thing that ticked it off, just because you had to wiggle.
Wiggle. Hell.
You had to wiggle the mouse in order for it to move faster. It would have been nice to just have it automatically move forward like Snake. You just move it forward, you just press left or right to go up and down to go, the directions.
Well, they have both, technically. They have directional pad,
but you still had to double tap. You had to press tap the left and right.
To move basically.
Yeah.
We had to tap really fast.
You have to really tap fast to move it down to like to a high jump. That's cool enough, but you should have made it at least a little bit more better where it will go forward. Even if it goes forward slowly, that would have been at least better. You have to like wiggle with the mouse or tap with the keys, and it's not that easy.
That's what makes it fun.
It makes it, yeah. The difficulty makes it always makes it fun, but you don't want to have it always difficult.
Yeah. Well, at the beginning, let the difficulty slowly raise up as you go progress.
Yeah. Started it off all hard because, we didn't know we had to tap it.
So, we gave it, even though we had that small hiccup, we still gave the playability a bar.
Yep.
I'm surprised. I know you're surprised. I'm surprised. But listen, we came to conclusion. Entertainment. Game was really entertaining.
Again, Snake, not to be.
Very entertaining. It's just like, I like the fleet aspect that you're seeing right now, the jumping and stuff. That's cool because you have to actually time that correctly to get them, and if you don't, you're not getting them at all. They're going to run away. That's kind of fun. I like when you have the enemies and you have to like try to hurt them, eat them, or before they eat you. That's kind of fun. It adds like the suspense level to where it keeps it more entertaining.
Yeah, also where you have to beat them that beat the most.
That's fun too. And then you gotta be careful because if they eat you, well, you're long as shit. Like, see how right here is like super long? If they eat you, you're losing half, pretty much whatever they cut off, you're losing that much. That's next up closest to your head. So you gotta play a little strategically and make it, it's very entertaining. It's very fun. I like the different aspects of the game. It keeps me entertained. While you're playing it, you're gonna wanna play more. Because you're like, oh fuck, okay, I gotta get the higher score, or I didn't beat it this time and I gotta do it over and redo it. game. Entertainment.
So far.
Now, three plays left. Let's take it away.
Replay that. I would replay it most, not all the time, but most of the time. More than half of it. Probably maybe when I get bored.
See, you saw that, right? Took off half his body. That's what I'm talking about.
But yeah, definitely. I'll play, you know, when I'm probably extra.
So something to pass.
Yeah.
For me, what I look for a replay value is a game that can keep coming back to me more. And like to say, basically, yeah, this wants you more. Like, I'll play something, I'll stop, and I'll be like, damn, I want to play a game again. Like, I want to pass this part. You know, that's what I look for. I wanted to do something different. Like, this is cool and all. I'll replay it, but it's something that I'll probably either get bored of after maybe a month or so, or I'll play it on my spare time after I'm like, not playing League of Legends, Destiny, or Dragon Age, or anything like that. So I'll go ahead and alright, let's play it. It's on my laptop anyway. But, you know, I'll play it. But I don't think I'll play this every day type of thing. But I still think you guys should actually give it a try because it really is fun. And that retro vibe will just get so fun. So we gave it a replay value, 3.5. So overall, this game got a 4.5. See the beginning. I mean, we like it. It's not too much fun about this game. It's irritating. Or keep it.
That's about the only comic
I've heard. Oh, look at that. Double snitch. I like this. They can eat the body and kill it, grow longer, faster. This game is fun. And if they go over their objective in the game or concept of both of them, you eat stuff, you grow, you take down your enemies, you eat their body, you grow. You know, that's a good thing. Basically.
Alright, guys. Description. It's always everything in the description. Also, our personal channel. Are there two on Twitter?
Basically, what he's trying to say is don't forget to like our shit, comment, subscribe, check our shit in the description. We'll catch you later.
Let us know what you want.
And in the comments, give us some feedback on the video. Do stuff on the way.
Deuces!
Hey, this is.